Hey y'all, welcome back to Dungeon Hack. Grab a snack. If you get stuck, read a fact. This is level 7. We just made our way through a bunch of trolls and grave mists and one, quote-unquote, groaning spirit. I think we all know what that really was. I think we made out okay. I mean, those trolls took forever to kill, but they weren't a huge threat. I mean, they did hurt a lot, but they were also really slow and relatively easy to avoid. So we're on a brand new level, and we don't know what to expect. Just to make sure everything's on the up and up, I'm going to go on ahead and recast all my spells, since I'm not sure what effects are still on me. Okay, so I'm already protected from evil. I'm probably going to have to rest pretty soon. I'm still invisible to undead. Man, this spell lasts forever. I'm really glad I took that. Okay, I didn't have aid, but I have that in effect now. I already had negative plane protection, but it never hurts to make sure. Alright, I didn't have prayer in effect. I have that now. I still have a flame strike in the spell quiver ready to go. So I'll have to remember that. And I guess we're good to go. Take out my holy symbol, put my shield back in. How close are we to leveling up? We're not that far away. I think it was 40 some thousand I needed to go up to level 10. So it's not unthinkable that I would get there before the end of this dungeon level. And the first thing we find is a key. Very Dungeon Hack-esque. Speaking of keys, I'm gonna drop that. That goes to a door that I apparently never found. I'm gonna drop that. I'm gonna drop these bracers. I won't need them anymore. I forget which. I only have the one mace, right? It's non-magical. Or no, that's a magic mace that I kept. Okay. I have a bunch of coins. If I find any slot machines, I'll have to drop those in. Use them more freely. I'm not going to use a throwing hammer, most likely. I doubt it's going to be better than spiritual hammer. Don't know what this chime does. Could be a chime of opening or a chime of hunger. Pretty sure those are the only two chimes. I doubt I'm going to use these bracers, even if they do have a magical effect that I'm not aware of, because what these bracers give me is just so good. So I have a detect magic, I have a protection from magic scroll that I'm not even sure if I can use. Protection from electricity. Oh, that's a mage spell too. I didn't notice. It doesn't say cleric, which means it's a mage scroll. Cleric scroll bless. That's a mage spell too, I guess. Or, I don't know, maybe not. Maybe those just aren't labeled as cleric spells. Not sure. Wand of magic missiles, that should be pretty fully charged since I only used it the once to test it out and see what it did. Slay living. I'll hold on to that just in case. Oops. Alright, what does level 7 hold for us? Oh, well, it holds a bone. Wait. Oh no, okay. I don't know what kind of lock that is. I thought that was a bone lock. It looks very similar. I don't know. Man, I'm kind of mad because there are two items in there. I can see them on the map. Oh my god, what is that? Oh man, it's fast, whatever it is. Oh lord. A sword wraith. I'm going to take a guess and say that's probably another undead enemy. Oh, I guess that's a stone lock. Okay. And another key. Great. Oh my god, they're so fast. What am I going to do? Well, if they're undead, then I'm pretty well protected against them. He's just swinging at me ineffectually over and over again. And a journal page, great. The sheet ghoul can spit a highly corrosive acid. Well, that would have been helpful to me 4 levels ago when I actually fought one. But no matter. Another cloak. Probably not going to be better than my armor, but I'll check it out just in case. Man, if these things can actually get through my defenses, it might not be a fun time. They get a lot of attacks on me. I want to go ahead and eat these rations. Why not? My food was getting close to yellow. Oh, by the way, the music is the Etrian Odyssey 4 soundtrack, which is composed by... oh god, there's another thing. It's composed by Yuzo Koshiro, the same composer of the Eye of the Beholder soundtrack from the last video. I don't know if that's undead or not. Looks like it might be. Man, it's giving me a lot of undead. Yeah, it's like skeletal, so... it hit me with whatever that attack was. It does a lot. Oh my god, 17 points of damage, really? Alright, what is this thing? Watch ghosts. Oh, I watched it alright. I watched it kick my butt. Heyo. How much healing do I have? Not much. I have one cure light wounds. I'm gonna have to rest again pretty soon. But yeah, I've been playing Etrian Odyssey 4. And I haven't even really paid attention to the music, because usually when I play a DS game, I'm either listening to something or watching something at the same time. So, I've been missing out on a pretty good soundtrack, it sounds like. I previewed this briefly before I started listening to it, and it's pretty enjoyable. Very appropriate for this kind of game. Spells of fire do not seem very effective against the undead beasts that roam these halls. Okay, well that's different than what I've heard about undead. But I'll take your word for it. Alright, do not have the jade for that lock. So gotta look around a little bit more. So far I prefer... what was that, a sword wraith? I prefer those over the... God, everything's a ghost and a wraith and a witch. I prefer the sword wraith over the watch ghost, because the sword wraith doesn't appear to be able to hit me. I don't think they've hit me yet. Of course, as always, in any kind of roguelike game, your cockiness will be your undoing. Oh, come on. I wonder if... I mean, their physical position, that can't affect your ability to hit them, can it? Because that guy was, like, standing off to the left, and my hammer kept going off to the right and missing. But, I mean, there's no way that can affect your ability to hit, can it? Doesn't seem like that would make sense. It was probably just a coincidence that I kept missing him. Alright, with these guys, I might have to employ a bit more... stick and move tactics. Luckily they have a projectile attack, which seems to be more easily dodgeable than melee attacks so far. I don't know, I haven't really uncovered how these enemies operate yet. Okay, that's where the hidden door was. I saw the watch ghost go through that wall, which is how I knew there was a secret door. Or an illusionary wall, rather. It's not really a door. Of course, if these things are ghosts, then they should be able to go through any wall. Can't they? Or is that a different ghost lore that I'm thinking of? The soundtrack's like 2.5 hours long, so I should be able to get a couple videos out of it, which would be nice. Now I have 3 of these silver keys. Great. Oh, there goes my hammer. Okay, let's get to a relatively safe spot. That's not it. Figure out what I did with my holy symbol. There we go. Bring the hammer back. Bringing the hammer down on you. Alright, well so far, I'm cautiously optimistic about this level. Because neither of these enemies seem as bad as the trolls. So far. I mean, the fact that they're both undead certainly helps. Maybe that journal page just meant a specific kind of undead was strong against fire, not all undead. Oh, another amulet. That's cool. Well, it's not a put it in your hand and use it kind of amulet. So I'll test wearing it in a second here as soon as I take out this ghost. Alright, are you cursed? Okay, you're not cursed. Do you affect my stats? Does not look like it. Well, Didn't I already do detect magic and this was non-magical, which means it's just a normal necklace? I think that might be the case. Pretty sure I found that blue gem looking necklace before and it was non-magical, so I won't maybe in a little bit I'll do another detect magic and see if I'm right, but I'm not going to worry too much about it. So, hope you guys are liking these long videos. I still don't know if this is the right way to go. If any of you have any feedback, then either leave a comment or send me an email or something. DukeOfTheBump@gmail.com. I mean, obviously, different people are going to have different opinions. But if the majority of people who watch my videos prefer shorter videos, then I might try to accommodate you. Alright, protection from evil wore off. I can't believe I'm still invisible to undead. Is this a glitch? Is that spell just lasting forever? Okay. Well, I am out of most of my spells, so I'm gonna go ahead and rest again. Seem to be in a relatively safe spot. Any changes I want to make to my spells? I think I'm good. Don't need great food and water yet. Want to hang on to negative plane protection while I'm still fighting undead stuff. It all looks good. Okay. Heal thyself. Still invisible to undead. I'm starting to think that must be a glitch. There's no way it lasts that long, right? Be gone, denizens of evil, for I am protected from you. Whoa, how come I only have two level 2 spells? That's weird. Shouldn't I have way more than that? I should have 4 spiritual hammers and 2 aids, right? Oh, I see. It was on the second page. I had to click the up arrow to get to the previous page. Makes sense. Alright. Is this the way I want to go? Yeah. Still have a couple passages to explore down here. So, as of this video, I'm still barely anywhere in Etrian Odyssey 4. I finished the Etrian Odyssey Untold demo and liked it a lot. I also finished the Bravely Default demo, and I'm sure I'll be getting that game at some point as well. Oh, another wand of magic missiles. I'll take it. But just at the moment, I'm more interested in an Etrian Odyssey kind of game than Bravely Default, which is why I picked up 4. But yeah, there's just a wealth of great RPGs on the 3DS. It's a great system to have if you're into RPGs. But yeah, still in crunch mode at work. It's not really crunch mode, it's just stress mode, so I haven't really had time for much extracurricular gaming. I'm actually looking forward to diving into it this Sunday. That'll be my gaming day for the week. Or no, actually this week it's going to be Saturday is my gaming day. And then I'm hanging out with people on Sunday. So yeah, I'm excited. I've been watching Pretty Good LP. Or I guess I should say listening to a Pretty Good LP. It's the game Fallout. The original Fallout. The LP... Oh no. I went into my camp menu, but I forgot. I'm no longer safe in my camp menu. I'm glad I learned that and didn't learn it the hard way. By hitting cam and just dying. But yeah, it's a guy named Grimith R. G-R-I-M-I-T-H. And the letter R. He did Fallout and Fallout 2. And he has a pretty good style. The first two Fallout games are games I've always been really interested in, but I tried playing the first Fallout, and it was just brutally, punishingly hard. So watching someone play it has been pretty fun. My bracers are better than those. I mean, really, I've just been listening to him play it since I've been at work for most of the time. I have watched a few episodes, but his form of narration is very good if you're just listening to it in the background. He does do something that a lot of people have complained about, and that's he reads a character's dialogue text aloud, and a lot of people don't like that in an LP, but for me it actually works really well since I can't always read the character dialogue myself. So, you know, beware if that's something you have strong feelings about. You might not enjoy that LP. But for me, it's perfect. That's actually something that's been preventing me from doing an LP of a text-heavy game. Like this, I mean, this is technically an RPG. But there's no characters to talk to, there's barely anything to read. Just the occasional journal entry. That's one sentence long, if that. So, not really that heavy on the text. But if I played, say, Shadowrun on the Genesis, which is one of my favorite RPGs, one of my favorite games in general, that game has a lot of text, and I don't know how I'd handle it if I actually did an LP of that game. I thought about it, but I still don't know how I'd handle it. I mean, I just feel so awkward sitting here reading the text in silence, and I never know how long to wait to give the viewer enough time to read the text. So reading it aloud just kind of solves both problems. There's no awkward silence, and I know exactly how long to wait. One of those things finally hit me. I have to say, that's a pretty good hit-miss ratio on those guys. I'm okay with that. Alright, still don't have that key. But yeah, any RPG with a lot of text that's not voiced, I'm not sure how I would go about doing that. I don't know, might be worth experimenting with. I have that key, don't I? Yeah. I had that key right at the beginning of this level. I thought it was, I thought the stone lock was the bone lock. Which is, you know, a real rookie mistake. I mean, that's rule number one of dungeon crawling is don't mix up your stones and your bones. I'm sure there's a sexual double entendre of some sort in there, but I'm not going to make it. I'll reference it. I will say that it exists, but I won't make that entendre myself. You're welcome. Like I said, this is a classy operation I'm trying to run. This is a family show, god darn it. I want an LP you can bring your kids to. Okay, not really. I do cuss a few swears every now and then. Ooh. Well, let's go down, get the experience, head back up. How close am I? I've got to be pretty close now. It's 400 something thousand. Of course, I thought it was 250,000 for level 9, and it was less than that. So I'm not sure. I might be closer than I think. That's a faith key that I need, I think. Okay, it's not a fire key. It's not a crystal key. I guess I don't have that one yet. But yeah, I've been trying to cut down on the number of swears that I cuss. Because, I mean, it's the internet. There's enough swears on the internet already. They don't need me adding to that already impossibly big number. Of course, I guess infinity plus one is still infinity, so really doesn't make any difference if I use profanity or not to the overall big picture. Man, where's my hammer? Hi, hammer. I have to say, this level, I'm okay with it. You see that thing's projectile flying down the hallway. It creates a blue dot for it, which is kind of interesting. Interesting that the ranged attacks are easier to dodge than the melee attacks. Usually, it's the other way around. Man, it threw two at me. What a jerk. Uh-oh. It's a dark zone. Dang it. And me without true sight. Well, there's some sort of lock here. Is it that? Nope. Is it that? Nope. Is it that? Nope. If I can just open this door, I can lure whatever's in that room out. And I can deal with them like that. Wait, oh, okay. I can see it from here, duh. So I need a green orb of some kind, which I don't have. I need a green orb, and I need a key of faith, I think, is what that other lock needed. I don't know. I don't remember what the lock with, like, a wreath around it like that is. I think it's faith, but I could be off the mark. Okay, well, where else do I need to go? I need to explore this hallway and this room. If I have the key to get into that room. I heard something take a swipe. I don't know. So, not much else going on with me, really. Just, it's been mostly work, and this, to be honest. Uh-oh. Okay, that was close. I had to do some fancy footwork to make sure I didn't get surrounded there. Alright, my aid spell expired, but that's not a big deal. Uh-oh, I'm dodging into uncharted territory here, which is never a good idea. Another silver coin. If you're backtracking to escape enemies, it's always better to backtrack into an area you've already uncovered to prevent, walking into another nest of enemies. Out of the frying pan and into the skillet, as some of us say. Alright, negative plane protection. Come on. Oh crap, I don't have it. Oh, please don't hit me. Please don't actually hit me. I should probably equip my shield to make sure he doesn't hit me. Okay. Alright, I'm out of negative plane protection. Can I rest here? That's the question. Okay, I do need to create food and water, though. So, let me go on ahead and cast that. There we go. Okay, so now I don't really need that spell. I don't need to create food and water at the moment. So let's get rid of that and get another negative plane protection. And see if it'll let me rest. Nope. Oh, that monster on the other side of the door is too close. How about right here? Excellent. Alright, negative plane protection. I have three of the suckers now, so hopefully it'll be a while before I run out. Yeah, that invisible to undead spell must be glitched. Because, I mean, it's still in effect, right? Let me try to cast it again. Already under the influence of it. That's a bug in my favor. And you know what? I'll take it. I'll take anything I can get at this point. I was almost like, where the heck are all my level 2 spells again? Then I was like, oh yeah. Alright. Okay, monsters. I am fully buffed. Oh hey, there's some rations on the wand there. Man, I am just spoiled for wands this game. I have a wand of... Well, I had a wand of cold. I don't know what happened to it. That's a bummer. Wands of cold are pretty good. But I have two wands of magic missiles. I have a wand of distance. And I have a wand of... was it this room or... I guess it wasn't this room. Where the heck was it? I just saw it. Oh, there it is. A poplar wand. As made famous in poplar... Oh, there's a trap here. That's a sound I kept hearing. It's a dart trap. Okay. As made famous in poplar mail. Was the joke I was about to make. Alright, where am I going? Let's head down. I have the amethyst. Ooh, what was that? Wand of acid. That might be good. Don't really know if I need it for these enemies, huh? Oh, come on, hammer. Oh, no. Uh-oh. See, that's a situation where a hotbar would have been really useful. Because I could have hit the number 3 and cast something good. I need to get out of here. Holy crap, I'm almost dead. I really hate the fact that I can't have my map and my spell list up at the same time. That's probably the number one flaw with this game, that it has a stupid compass here, instead of just making room for this and my spell list. Bad UI designers, bad. No cookie. That's right. Oh fuck, I walked right into that dart. Okay. That's right. No cookie. I'm tough but fair. Alright, is there a button for this door or anything? I'm not seeing one. Is there any other way in? Oh yeah, okay. That's connected to that one up there. Awesome. Do I have that key? I don't think I do. Nope. Okay, well, where to now? Have not been this way. There's really not that much left. I'm only half an hour into it and this level's almost done. Feeling pretty good. Alright, can't open that door. That only opens from the other side. Unless there's a button I'm missing, which doesn't look like it. Man, that guy. He wants to get at me. Or a lady. It might be a lady. I don't know. It's hard to tell when they're skeletal. Purple mallets. Not to be used as a weapon. For decoration only. Well, for decoration and banging gongs that mysteriously open doors. And some of the quote-unquote locks in this game just make absolutely no sense. I mean, who would design... Yes! Level 10! Booyah! Ding! Ding, baby! Ding. Oh, crap. Uh-oh. Oh, no, 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 no. I've used all the charges! No! Okay. Well, it's actually pausing now. Maybe I was mistaken before when I heard noises in the camp menu. Oh my god, what am I going to do? I'm not surrounded. There's nothing behind me, it looks like. Can I close that door? Okay, thank god. Oops, I did not need to cast that again. I wanted to switch over to my level 1 spells. Cast all these cure light wounds. It's not much, but I gotta get myself some emergency hit points. Those watch ghosts do a lot of damage. It's no joke. I mean, I'm at a pretty good advantage chance to hit wise with all these buffs that I have, but if they do hit, holy crap. I think I'm gonna rest again. I know I'm a coward, but I have a safe spot to rest. I want to get all my spells back. Alright. That was close. My heart's racing. This is a pretty good game. I'm having fun playing this. I mean, it has its flaws, and I've complained about those flaws on multiple occasions. But you know, it's freaking tense, man. I mean, that was a dire situation. Potion of Confusion. You can actually throw these at enemies, I think, to confuse the enemies, which is cool. I mean, thank God I could actually go into my camp menu, otherwise I would have been done for. I must have misheard, because I thought I heard enemies moving around and attacking while I was in the camp menu. But that must have been, maybe it was part of the music. But I don't think so. So I kind of fudged that. I mean, really, in all fairness, I shouldn't have survived that. I played right into the enemy's hands. Fell right into their trap. Key of Faith. Okay. So yeah, that was a lock of faith that I needed. So I think that's all the keys I need. I have in my inventory now, so I can go and unlock these last few doors. Oh wait, I don't have that one yet. It must be... It's either in the Faith Room or the Emerald Room. So I need to go... I forget if that door is locked or if it just doesn't open from that side. Let me double check. Okay, so this door just doesn't open from that side. So where are the other doors? I have one down here. And... Looks like that's it. Other than the one, I think that's a copper key that I need. Oh, I remember. There was a door in the dark zone that I couldn't open because I needed the emerald. Where was the dark zone? I forget. It's not here. That's a copper one. It's not here. That's the door that only opens from the other side. Oh, I bet an enemy opened that door. That's why that's not filled in, but the door's open. Alright, so let's head that way, I guess. I didn't know the enemies could open locked doors. Wait. Okay, yeah, that's that door. So I need to go on a pretty convoluted path with a lot of enemies. But I should be okay. At least I'm assuming the enemies open the door. I don't know how else it would be open if that wasn't the case. I'm gonna go ahead and use that. Why not? I have all these silver coins burning a hole in my pocket. You know, when that sorceress lady sent me in this dungeon, she said I would find gold and gem enough for any man. And I've only found like 2 gold coins. Oh, okay, is that door? I just didn't have a chance to go in here. I found like 2 gold coins, and I found a bunch of gems, but every gem I found, I need to open a freaking lock. So hopefully, there's a much larger pile of golden gems at the end of all this. I mean, otherwise, kind of messed up for the sorcerers to send me in here without any guarantee of payment. She was just like, oh yeah, you'll find some treasure, don't worry. It'll be fine. Okay. Cannot set a waypoint, so I had to study the map there for a second to figure out exactly which way I wanted to go. Oh. So there's that dark zone, or is that a different dark zone? Well, there's no skull lock, so that must be a different dark zone. Interesting. So, how much are you paying me again? Don't worry about it. This dungeon is loaded. You'll find so much awesome shit there. Like, you won't even know what to do with all of it. Seriously, bro. Well, you know, I can't pay my rent with freaking hammers. If I could, I wouldn't even be in here. Because I can make infinite hammers. I mean, I guess technically I am paying my rent with hammers because, I mean, I'm using a hammer to eventually acquire the money that would be spent on rent. Assuming I actually find some stuff. And there's that brass key. I was mistaken. It was brass, not copper. Alright, so I have one more door I need to open, right? Oh no, I have 2 more doors. Oh, okay. I bet that's the dark zone down there. That's the copper key. Alright. And there's no short way to get there. But once I open this door, it's a pretty short walk to this door, and then the exit's right there. So, level 7 is almost complete. And I'm going the wrong way. No, this is the right way. It's just an incredibly long and convoluted winding path. So I hope you guys have a chance to catch up on any videos you've missed over the weekend or just haven't had time to watch. Oxbow, one of my viewers, pointed out to me that my laser cat video is screwed up and you can only watch like the first 30 seconds of it before it stops playing, and it appears to be a problem that's not fixing itself. So on Saturday, if it's still a problem, I'll probably re-upload the laser cat video, because luckily I have a backup. So if you haven't watched that yet, check it out. There's lasers and trivia questions. Except that there's actually not any lasers. I know, it's called Laser Cat. You would think there would be lasers on it, but... Uh-oh. Whee! I don't know, I kind of like an enemy throwing an attack I can actually dodge. Not just taking a swing, and then 5 seconds later when I'm 10 steps away, the swing actually connects. Where's my hammer? Oh, there it is. I love it when that happens. All right. Okay. So I still haven't fully explored this room. I just lured some of the monsters out. Is there any? Is there anything in here? Oh. Well, that answers that question. And of course, there's nothing in here. But you know, I have to be thorough. Well, okay, I don't have to be thorough, but I want to be thorough. I like thoroughness in dungeon crawlers. What the? Man, my hammer, it kind of freaks out when I throw it and then walk in front of it. Like, it starts flying in the opposite direction or something. I don't actually know what happened there. I need to give my hammer room to breathe before I start running towards it. You know, for all I know, whatever those things are throwing at me is some kind of petrify attack that I'm immune against since I have my ion stone. I don't know how that's actually pronounced. It's I-O-U-N. I'm saying ion because that's the word it kind of resembles. Ion? Ion? I don't know if that's actually a thing or if it's just something they made up for D&D. I mean, I'm sure magical stones that fly around your head aren't actually a thing. But they might be based on some sort of actual artifact called an ion stone. Or ion stone, or whatever. So yeah, Laser Cat this Saturday. Look forward to it. What the hell was that noise? Wait. Oh, okay. I already got that passage. I heard something that I did not like the sound of. But I already fought the boss for this level. It was the screeching ghoul or whatever. The howling spirit. The crying spook. Or was that the last level? I don't really remember. Maybe the game's just making noises sometimes to freak me out. Psychological warfare. Kind of like how in Doom 3, there were scripted events where, like, you would hear creepy, ghostly whispers that weren't actually coming from anything. Potion of invisibility. Nice, that'll come in handy. Hold on a second. Groaning spirit. I was just making sure I didn't kill something that I wasn't aware of. But no, not yet. Hey, a table. Well, it's more than I find in most rooms. Uh-oh. No. Okay. Really glad these sword rays couldn't hit the broadside of a barn if it had a giant target painted on it. Oh, that was just my aid spell. I thought it was negative plane protection expiring and I was about to run. Whoosh, whoosh. Whoosh, whoosh. Man, that hallway is too long. I need to get to a smaller hallway. There we go. Fire! Fire 2! Fire 3! Just keep firing, I don't know. You'll hit something eventually. Alright, is there anything in the table? Oh! Okay, well that answers that question. It's one of those ogre slugs, right? I'll tell you what, ogre slug. How do you feel about a little bit of flame strike? Bam! That didn't look like it did much. But it was worth a shot. Oh my god, that thing sounds disgusting. It looks disgusting. Reminds me of the, that's a bad hallway. Oh, that's a bad hallway too. Reminds me of the Mancubus from Doom 2. Oh, shit. Whew. I'm really glad I killed that thing, because my Amulet of Imminent Return is out of charges. I should probably just toss this since I'm not going to be able to use this anymore. Alright, found another Ion Stone. It's not cursed. How does it affect my stats, if at all? Doesn't look like it does. Well, it does something good. All of the Ion Stones are good, I think. I'm not sure if there are any cursed ones. Alright, and with that... Oh, wait. There's the room with the ogre slug, I forgot. I doubt there's anything in here, but... You guys thought you were done. But not yet. Not quite yet. Well, the ogre slug didn't seem that bad. I don't know, maybe I did hit it with the flame strike. It sure didn't seem like it did any damage. Okay, hammer. Oh, it expired. I was waiting for my spiritual hammer to come back to me. Come back to me, hammer. Don't leave me. So now I have two magical stones encircling my head, which isn't distracting at all, I'm sure. Wait, do I need to go that way? No, I don't. I need to go this way, because I am finally done with this level. That is a thoroughly explored map. Welcome to level 8. Save my game. Thanks for watching. Happy Friday. Have a good weekend, everyone. I will be back on Monday with another episode. And four more after that. And then another weekend. I hope you're excited. I know I sure am. I'm having a lot of fun. Hope you are. And I will see you soon. I'm Duke of the Bump. Goodbye.